I've been in Singapore for about a few days now, and I'm staying in this one bedroom hotel. This is like one of the first spots where I've had that is like to myself, and I don't really have a roommate. And I'm staying in here for the next 8 weeks because I'm doing an internship abroad. For the last few nights, I've just kind of been shopping around, meeting new people, making new friends, going out to eat. I also visited this hawker center where they filmed Crazy Rich Asians. But fast forward, we are here now, and I got some work that I still need to finish back home, and I want to try to get a gym membership. The thing about this experience is that last year, I didn't really travel alone because I had a group to go with, but this is one of the first times where I kind of just came here on my own, and now I am living on my own. And the friends that I make are the people that I'll be hanging out with, you know, as I go along this journey. I also got a chance to go check out the Marina Bay at night when they had all the lights on, and that was probably one of the best views I've ever seen.
Oh my god.
This is so fucking crazy. Actually, straight out of Crazy Rich Asians. I don't feel I lose them, my dreaming. Is them more like cars got me feeling like it's so. Psych, I need to grab the camera. Love is when you try to place it out your mind, but you can't turn the radio down, and you can't think of anyone. Alright, so as I mentioned earlier, I'm pretty much here for the next 8 weeks because I am doing an internship. The internship that I'm doing is related to like social media, content development. And so yeah, that's gonna be really cool because for the past like 2 years, you know, I've been doing this whole, you know, camera, video editing, photography, kind of just on my own and as a freelancer. And so it's gonna be really interesting to see how that works out and whether or not I still have a passion for it, even though it's in a work setting. You know, oftentimes like when people start working their passions, you know, their passions become, it becomes mundane. And they lose sight of, you know, why they started in the first place. So hopefully, you know, me doing this internship doesn't make me lose sight of why I love creating content and why I love doing photography and videography in the first place. That said, for the past few months, I've been doing photo shoots. And most recently, I was doing a lot of grad photo shoots. And this is probably like the first time that I'm actually getting paid for my projects. And so there's been this, I guess, pressure to make sure I actually keep up to par and, you know, make myself a professional. Before, I would make content for myself and not for anybody else. So if I disappoint anybody, I'd be disappointing myself. But now it's like I have people that I don't want to disappoint. I also got to work for a competitive dance team at UCSD. Their name's Ascension, and I basically helped them film their concept video, which was a pretty cool experience. I've never done something like that before, and so it was kind of scary and daunting to do that. It's always interesting to have to create for other people because, you know, they're sharing with you their creative vision, and it's your job to execute that. And it's very different being a creator myself and having the visions and the ideas in my head and to execute it myself the way I see it. But if you guys are interested in checking that video out and seeing what I've been working on, then you can click the link in the description. Just a little plug for them. I can see your face in the Parisian paintings. The Mona Lisa, I can hear your. By the way, I don't start my internship until like another week or two just because I need a like work visa here in Singapore. And unfortunately, my appointment isn't until the 30th. I also got furikake fries because, you know, I love french fries and I love potatoes.
All right, so I know I'm in a different country and everything, but I love my potatoes. And more importantly, my potato chips. To my cop for the room. I was about to give you all of me on all the weekends, and
all I wanted was apologies and all of your bed. Alright, so one of the goals that I had when I came to Singapore was that I need to get back in my gym grind. For the past, like, I don't know, say maybe 2 months, I had a gym membership, but I didn't really use it, nor did I go, just because, you know, I was really busy with like grad shoots and other projects that I want to work on and complete. And because of that, I pretty much just put aside like my health and like my fitness journey and just did these projects instead. But I'm hoping that by moving here, I'll like be reinvigorated and be re-inspired to like work out again, just because I might have fallen into like a routine. I might have gotten too comfortable with like where I was and like where I lived back in San Diego. And so maybe coming here would be like a motivator for me. I don't know. We'll see. And then also I heard the gym memberships here are quite expensive in Singapore, probably like $100 a month, but I'm only here for 2 months. So $200, you know, maybe money will make me want to actually work out just because it's so expensive. I might as well go since I'm paying that much. Hi, I was actually thinking about getting a membership. I'll be here for 2 months, 8 weeks. So like last year, I studied abroad in Korea. The problem with going back to Korea and doing like round two is that I would associate the memories that I had with those people. So the best way that I thought to travel again and like kind of get that same feeling is to like start fresh, start clean. So essentially just kind of like going to a new location, like new map, new characters, you know, new season, new battle pass. And just like how I missed my time back in Korea, I know that once this whole Singapore experience is over, that I'm gonna miss this too. But anyways, let's start this workout. I don't even know if I stretch properly. You know, I completely forgot that
This is all in kilograms and not pounds.
I like you, I do. We went over to France and we woke up in Japan. I like you.
I forgot to drink. I need a drink.
Oh girl, I know you only like it fancy. So I pull up in that Maybach candy.
Alright, so right now we're at one of Hawking Centers, which is under our hotel. I got the rice gumbam with pork chop. What'd you get, Jeff?
Actually, yeah, I got the same thing.
Low-key, his food came out. I was like, damn, that shit looked good, so I wanted one. So yeah, sticking to our tradition. But yeah, we're probably gonna eat dinner now, and that is probably gonna be the end of the vlog.